My bad. Take two. Let's try this again. All right. You can see me if you can hear me. Put your city in the comments. We're gonna try this again. Thank you for tapping the screen, y'all. It helps alert other people that we are live. Today we're gonna talk about target audience. Let me see if I can put it back on the screen. I was just live and it went out. If you can hear me, if you can see me, put it your city in the comments. Let me shout a couple people out. Hope the other people that were here come back. Okay, all right, I'm back. All right, if y'all don't mind, just tap the screen and that helps alert other people that were live. Today we're gonna talk about target audience. Hey, Nat, excuse me. Talk about target audience. So if you are somebody who's struggling with getting sales, somebody who's struggling to communicate your marketing message on social media, we're gonna talk about target audience. We're gonna talk about target audience. Thank you for joining. All right, I'm gonna get back into it and the people that were just here will come back. So a target audience is a specific group of people that you serve or solve a problem for. Target audience is a group of people that you serve or solve a problem for. They share similar goals, lifestyles, interests, desires, problems. So it goes beyond their 18 to 35. It goes beyond their male or female. Target audience is a specific group of people that you serve or solve a problem for. So it's very important to know with your target audience their pain points. Important to know what their pain points are. So what I would recommend doing and what I tell people that I coach or consult with is one of the things that you can do when you're trying to figure out if you've never had a customer before and this is your first time launching, this is your first time out here, the first thing you can do is go on Reddit. Reddit is a forum where people discuss various topics. You go on Reddit, you type in the product, you type in the service, whatever it is, and you just kind of sift through to see what people are saying. A lot of times on there, if somebody tried, I don't know, a flat iron, they'll go on there and said, I had blah, 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 flat iron, and this is what I didn't like about it, or this is what I loved about it. So you go on there and you take notes. Sometimes that's spending, good afternoon, sometimes that's spending maybe 20 minutes a day and just gathering research. This is why a lot of people fail at target audience, because they don't want to do the work. They want it to just be handed to them. You really have to go do the work so you know that if you get it early on in the beginning, it'll make the journey easier. You won't just be, oh, I'm just selling this. I'm trying to sell this highlighter and I'm just going to keep posting about it. You got to understand who needs this highlighter. What problem does this highlighter solve? So you have to be able to learn the language of your target audience. And when you go in those places like Quora or Reddit, your target audience is there speaking. They're telling you what they don't like. They're telling you what they do like. I remember when I was doing some research about Christian single women, I went in Reddit and I literally saw what they were struggling with, what their problems were. A lot of them said they struggled with trusting God or they felt like God was taking too long. So if I'm a marketer and if I'm somebody that sells, I don't know, workbooks or journals, I can literally make a journal about how to wait on God when you're believing him for a spouse. There's a problem, right? I know that they're struggling with this and I can give them tips and advice on how to ease that struggle or how to make it through that struggle or not to see it as a struggle. All right. So you can go on. You can do that with Reddit. You can probably kind of do that with Facebook groups too. Some of those Facebook groups have been like a little spammy and stuff. But you can still go on there and see what people are saying. When I used to do more so like marketing or things like that, I used to go on those Facebook groups and like a specific group, not just any old church group or anything like that, a group that's around marketing. And I would literally search people, like how I would put quotes around how to, or and see what people were writing in the group around whatever topic. And then I would know from that what content to create. I would know from that what content to create. So you can do that on Reddit. You could do that on Quora. You could do that in Facebook groups. You can also go look on YouTube to see what people want. A lot of people leave reviews on YouTube. You can go on YouTube and see what people are complaining about in regards to your product or service, what they're struggling with. You got to realize on social media, people tell you way more than they need to. You ever go on, I like to think of Quora as more like Target. And Reddit is more like Walmart. When you go on Reddit, you never know what you're going to get, what you're going to see. But it's a wealth of information that will really, really help you. So I would do that. Another thing is, if you have, let's say you have a known competitor. Let's say you sell inspirational jewelry and somebody like Alex and Ani or James Avery or Pandora are people you consider to be your competitors. You can go look at their FAQs on their website. You can go look at their reviews and see what people are saying. You can go look in their comment section on their Instagram page or their Facebook page and see what people are saying. People will tell you their complaints, what they really love about the product. You can also use Amazon. Oh my God, this is like gold. If you take a note, make sure Amazon is on there, big letters and highlighted. But you can literally, let's say you're selling, I don't know, some type of fitness thing, right? And it's a popular item that other people sell. You can literally go on Amazon, type in that fitness product, and look at the reviews people are leaving. People may say, this one didn't come with instructions, or this was missing this, or I didn't get this out of this, and that might help you to also improve the product. When you bring, maybe you're gonna introduce something else to the market. You can say, okay, so people were complaining about this program didn't do this. Let me see how I could take this to the next level. Y'all picking up what I'm putting down? If you're picking up what I'm putting down, throw some hearts in the chat. Throw some hearts in the chat if you understand what I'm saying. If you're picking up what I'm putting down, throw some hearts in the chat. Throw some hearts in the chat. I know some people are used to me coming on here. Thank you so extra for pinning that. Coming on here and talking spiritual. And yeah, we do that all the time. But for people that want to build a business, you need target audience. Thank you, Kay. You need target audience. You need to understand before you think about sales, before you think about, oh, I need to make $5 million a year. You need to know your audience. And a lot of people mess that up. A lot of people mess that up. This is probably takes the longest in when building a business, because you want to make sure you get this right in the beginning. You want to make sure you get this right. So another thing is too, if you already have an existing audience, you already been selling products, it's a little bit more easier for you because you can look at the data. You can look at the analytics. You can see different things about your customer in your personal data. You can also, and this is something I used to do back in the day, I used to survey my existing clientele and I used to ask them, what do you like about this product? What you don't like about this product? Look at the data. What product has sold the most overall? That tells you something. That tells you there's something they liked about that, right? What product is not moving? If it's not moving, it might be a reason for you to get rid of it, right? Think about that. What do you get the most compliments on with your products or with your services? Think about things like that. All of that is data for you to record and to sit down and sit with it. Do surveys, questionnaires, and things like that. Always think about this, though. What problems does your product solve? What problems does your product solve? You sell a t-shirt. What is that t-shirt problem solve? Why does somebody need your t-shirt? You need to think about that. Who benefits from it? Who benefits from your product or your service? Who benefits from it? And then I want y'all to know this too. There's like four types of audiences, right? You have one, users, people who use your product. That's one. Then you have buyers. People who buy your product. Because a lot of times, there are times where people buy your product, but they're giving it as a gift to somebody else. That doesn't mean that they're going to use it. So you have users, people who will use the product. You have buyers, people who will buy the product. You have beneficiaries, people who benefit directly from your product. People who benefit directly from your product. In that case, it could be a mom buys a toy for her child. The child is going to directly benefit, not necessarily the mom, right? And then you have influencers, people who encourage the sale or use of a product, service, or solution. And I'll repeat that if I need to. There's four types of audiences: users, buyers, beneficiaries, and influencers. Those are all different types of audiences, right? So I was watching, one of these high-level masterminds for marketing a few days ago, and they were talking about a strategy that they were getting ready to implement in their business was not necessarily selling directly to the end user, but selling to the person that buys the gifts. I think it was, might've been something in the wedding industry, photography or something like that. And they were saying they were gonna target the person who was gonna buy the bride, for who paid for the bride photography. I think they're gonna target like the fathers or the moms or something like that. So that's another strategy as well when you're getting ready to, you know, expanding your business, targeting a specific type of person that may not use the product, but they'll gift it to somebody else. You think about Mother's Day is coming, Easter is coming, Resurrection Sunday is coming. Thank you for the gifts. All of those things are coming, right? So you wouldn't necessarily sell to the child the baskets, right? You would sell to the parent or the grandparent or somebody that's typically buying those types of baskets. Or Mother's Day is coming, right? You're not directly selling to the mom. You may sell to the child that's going to give to the mom, right? Or the daughter, or the son, or the son-in-law, or the daughter-in-law, however. So just thinking about those type of things too, in regards to your business. So does anybody need me to repeat? Thank you for the heart meat overflow. Anybody need me to repeat? We were talking about target audience, and it's very, very important. Everybody's city, state is different when it comes to LLC. You need to look at your chamber of commerce in your particular area, because it's not the same in every state and every city. It's not the same in every state and every city. So I would contact your business chamber of commerce, I think it's called. You can easily look that up online and see how to go about it, because it's not one size fits all. I really enjoy your powers and real Christian lady. I do give glory. Oh, thank you. Appreciate that. God is good. We thank him, y'all. If there's anybody in business, this is crucial. You got to know your target audience. I can't tell you how many times I see people on social media and they just post them because they want sales. And I get it. That's a part of business. But if you're selling to everybody, you're selling to nobody. Selling to everybody, you're selling to nobody. Okay, she said in Georgia is the Secretary of State. I'm not sure where that person is at. Is this for anyone wanting to start a business? Yeah, because you need a target audience to sell to. It's for anybody. You need a target audience to sell to. You need to know who you're selling to, because if you're selling to everybody, you're selling to nobody. Thank you, Don. You're selling to everybody, you're selling to nobody. So you gotta know who it is before you go out and think you're about to just build this big old business. You want to start with researching. Who needs my product? What problem am I solving? The wealthiest people in the world, they solve problems. They're not worried about the money. They're not worried about the risk. They solve problems. So even if you're just trying to figure out what do you want to sell, what do you want to create, figure out where's the problematic areas. Where does there need a solution? The top areas to sell products in is wealth, health, and relationships. Wealth, health, and relationships are like the top areas. Not saying those you only can do those, but those are the top. Those are the top like niches. Thank you so much for the roses. I appreciate it. Okay. Any questions about target audience? This is actually with the membership. We open up on Friday. This is one of the first lessons we're talking about is target audience. So if you're in the membership, you're going to get this times three. Thank you so much, y'all, for the gifts. I appreciate them. And for liking. That really helps. Target audience. Remember this. It's a specific group of people that you serve or solve a problem. They share goals, they share lifestyles, interests, desires, problems. Think about some of the things that you connect to. Think the things that you like, the things that you purchase. You don't purchase things just because, oh, I'm 25 and this looks cute, or I'm a female and this looks cute. It goes beyond that. It goes beyond that. It goes beyond that. It goes beyond that. If you're selling to everybody, you're selling to nobody. You want to make sure you are very, very specific in what you're selling. Even when Jesus, we're going to talk about Jesus for a moment. Even when he spoke in parables. Not everybody understood that. That was for a specific type of people. That's exactly what a target audience is. It's a language that's specifically for them. Your great grandmother may not understand it. Your father may not understand it, but you understand it because you connect to it because you're part of that audience. So it's speaking the language that the person needs. It's solving their problem. It's presenting them with a solution and saying, hey, this highlighter is one of the best highlighters because it can do this, 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 and this. And it lasts 10 months. How many highlighters do you know will last 10 months, right? And speaking to who would need a highlighter? Who needs a highlighter? Maybe somebody in business. Maybe somebody in school is speaking to that. Hey, concept and design is speaking to that. But I'm telling y'all, one of the biggest clutches is going on Reddit. Going on Reddit. I taught this in my Faceless Brand Workshop. We went on Reddit for content ideas. And I gave them like a something to type in Google. And I wish I had it, but I don't remember it. Something to type in Google to figure out struggles of whatever their target audience was going through. And when they searched on Google, it popped up exactly Reddit and exactly what people were saying in that specific industry or niche. So Reddit is definitely clutch. Reddit is definitely clutch, y'all. Definitely clutch. All right. Any questions about target audience? I said I was going to do some TikTok audits today, but my other phone is on the other side of the screen. Let me see. If I could pull up TikTok on my computer, I might be able to do it. Does anybody have a TikTok page? Well, let me log in before I open my mouth and say that. Because I don't be knowing my password. So if it doesn't work, then I can't do it. But if I do... So they let me, hold on, you know, when you signing in, they show you all the stuff. I was going to try to see if I could do a TikTok audit, basically look at your TikTok page and give you some critique. God, let's try this. Hold on, I got that two-factor on here. Let's see. If this works, then I will maybe do like two people who drop their handle, and I can give you some critique on your TikTok. Okay. Drop your hand if there's anybody who wants me to look at their TikTok page. Now, make sure it's a page that you're trying to get business, sales, clients. I ain't doing no personal page. But if you have a TikTok page and you want me to look at it really quickly, I can pull it up here on my computer and give you some critique about it. And give you some critique about it. I'm gonna turn my volume down because this TikTok thing just starts playing all of a sudden. Y'all know darn well I don't listen to no Beyonce. Is there anybody on here who wants a TikTok audit? I ain't gonna stay too long asking. I normally don't do this, but I will do it today. Is there anybody on here who wants me to look at their TikTok page? I'm about to say going once, going twice, and then it's done. Okay, what's your TikTok name? Is it the one you commented from? Is it the one you just comment? All right. Hold up. Helps her. Win. Oh, wait, it pops up too. Let's see. I like your bio. I help women in their marriage and win in their finances with digital products. That's awesome. Straight to the point. Straight to the point.
God is sending your husband home. Listen to me. God is sending your husband back home. I don't care what it looks like.
This is good. It has the captions on here.
What is happening in the natural. We walk by faith and not by what we see. God is going to...
I would say, though, with your videos, you can reach more people if you put a little bit more in the description. That one actually did got a good amount of views, but I would put more in the description. You go to the search engine on TikTok and type in marriage. It might be a little too generic, but I'll see. Marriage, and then you scroll down. It'll give you a list of what people are searching for in TikTok. On here right now, I see black marriage TikTok, marriage humor, black marriage, marriage quote, restoring broken marriage, marriage goals, marriage quotes that hit and it's cut off. Marriage motivation, marriage advice, black husband with black wife, marriage. It gives you a whole list of things that people are actually searching for. So I would, if it makes sense to the video that you're gonna create, I would insert that into the description. I would use some of those as hashtags. I'm trying to scroll down to see if it gives you more. I know on the cell phone, it gives you a lot what people are searching for. So this is helpful too. Anybody that's creating content, all you have to do is go on TikTok search engine and type in whatever your keyword is, and it'll tell you exactly what people are searching for, and you can create content around that. So if I know people are searching restoring broken marriages, I probably would do a video about God restoring broken marriages, or scriptures when you're believing God to restore a marriage, or some type of marriage motivation or marriage advice, right? If marriage is your specialty, you want to come across as being the expert in marriage. Let me see, I can go back there. Let me see if I could go back to your page and see, but I definitely like that. Let's see. Do you have, I know on the desktop version, you can't tell if somebody has a playlist. If all of these parts, if you don't have a playlist, I would create a playlist and put all of these parts together.
Right? I was still young in it, and God was telling me.
And then you can name it how God will help you overcome the other woman. Whole playlist around that. And then maybe put something in the description that talks about the other woman. Let me see what. We type in other women on TikTok. What are people searching in regards to that? Let's see. Other, not older. Let's see. Other woman advice, the other woman, being the other woman in the relationship, other woman trend, being the other girl, always another girl, message to the other woman. That's interesting. You might can do a little bit something with that. And then whenever you guys put the keywords in the search, look at some of these top videos that pop up, because normally it's based off of who got the most views, and see what they're talking about. And if you go and watch that video and you're like, oh, but they didn't touch on this point, or I can revamp this, go and do that. Make it fresh, make it new. Don't copy, but just make it better. Like, let's say there was somebody on here talking about 5 ways to be the other woman, and then I would make a video of 5 reasons you don't want to be the other woman. The other woman doesn't get this. The other woman doesn't get that. The other woman, you're not in covenant, you know, things like that. Let's go back to your page and see. I think you got good content though. I would just put a little bit more of keywords in your description. Use more marriage hashtags. Maybe use maybe 3 to 5 hashtags in there. If you don't have playlists, definitely do playlists. Make sure in some of the videos that you don't have a description, you put a description. I don't know if they let you edit and go back, but if you can, do that, because I see some without it. But that definitely helps tell the algorithm where to send this video to. Definitely, the videos where we talk about like signs for this or how to do this in your marriage, people like stuff like that. People like to be told what to do. Prayers for your marriage, scriptures for your marriage, how to hear God in your marriage, things like that. People like, other than that, I think you're doing well. I just think you got to just tweak a couple things and then be okay. I like that you put the description, or the caption on the video so people could see it. Cause they say that a good percentage of people watch the videos without, sound. So that's good. Divorce is a demonic spirit. I love that. And then talking about that, God versus divorce. Yeah, you have really good content. Just go on Reddit is one, to see what people are talking about in regards to marriage, divorce, all the topics that you talk about, see what people are talking about. And then also go on answerthepublic.com. Answerthepublic.com and type in whatever your keyword is, and they're going to give you a list of what people are searching in Google. What people are searching in Google. It's ongoing, so it's every month. Every month we drop a masterclass, and then we have like a event or something every month. So it's ongoing. It's not just one time. It's ongoing. Yeah, you have really good content, right? So keep going with that. Appreciate that. You go to the link in my bio. Go to the link in my bio. We actually have a masterclass in the, it opens up on Friday, but we have a masterclass in there about TikTok marketing too. But we're going to do a whole nother one. But the first thing we got to target in this membership is target audience. Is target audience. Who else dropped their page that I missed? Put it again so I don't have to scroll up. If I miss your comment, sorry, I was looking at this. Somebody else. And then you talk about finances too. Put incorporate that in there too. Because I didn't see anything about finances. You can say how to be, you know, how to be a married woman with your finances in order. Okay, the official, let me pull it up. The official to be cheap. Micro links and health hair coach and specialist in Orlando. Awesome, that's good. Let's see this one.
So this student came in today and she has been dusting her ends for a year. I am not a fan of dusting. And read the caption, I'll tell you why. But I went in and did a really good detailed trim on her hair where I was able to
I would even do a video about what dusting is and why it's not good for your hair or whatever your stance on dusting. I would do that. I like the voiceover stuff because people love that.
So this is a new client that came in.
People love the voiceovers.
A trim or a cut, whatever you like to call it.
You can talk about the difference between a trim and a cut. Show what unhealthy hair looks like versus healthy hair. You can do that. Since you are... your target audience is probably local. I would make sure I use hashtags that are around Orlando. Let me see if you what I see for your hashtags.
So this client came in.
Okay, so you have Tampa, you have Orlando. Okay, so that's good. That's good. Let's see. Before and afters would do very, very well. Let's see on this one. And you can do some of those point of view videos. Point of view when you get your hair done, how you feel different or how you feel better or how you got to show it off. Those do very, very well. I think people are liking your voiceover videos. So I think you should do a lot more voiceover videos. Because the only thing with some of these sounds, they get muted. I see a couple of them have been muted for you. So that way the voiceover will help. Let's see. Explaining what a traditional sew-in versus what other type of sew-ins that you have, or how to get the flat install, how to get it flat, talking about things like that. That actually was really, really good. How to get that, let's see. You can show the difference between natural and relaxed. There's so much stuff you can do. People like, I don't want to say hair porn, but hair porn is a thing. Let me type in black hair and see what comes up. As far as keywords, okay, so you have black hair care, pale skin. So people are searching that black hair effect, black hairstyles, black hair transformation. People like transformation videos. I would keep that in mind. Black people hair, best black hair dye. So even if you dye, if that was your specialty, you can talk about the best dye for African American hair. You can talk about somebody's looking up, somebody's asking about black hair, black dye specifically. So doing that, but those transformation videos, point of view videos, before and after definitely would help. Keep your voice on it though. I like the voiceovers for you. I would keep your voiceovers. Let me see what else we can do. Black hairstyles for black hair growth is another one. We can talk about that. Black hairstyles for black women. Let's do natural hair care and see what comes up. Let's see. Best products. You can recommend products. If there's some, like maybe your top three that you use at the salon, you can talk about that. You can talk about how to care for natural hair. You can talk about what's the thing called? Protective styles to use for the spring. Spring is getting ready to come. Or three protective styles that you're gonna need for the summer, things like that. I remember during the pandemic, I was helping somebody with their hair, one of their hair pages, I think it might've been Instagram or Facebook, but I was telling them like how to have your hair to survive during the pandemic. You can do a video about when you're stay at home, work from home, parent, mom, how to take care of your hair in between salon visits and things like that. I know I'm missing a lot of the comments. I'm missing a lot in the comments. Yeah. Well, actually, we're talking about somebody's hair care page, so. It's the link in my bio for the journals. For the journals, the link in the bio. You're welcome. But yeah, do the voiceovers. I love that. I love that. The before and after, the transformation. People like transformations. People like transformations. And then treat your Instagram and TikTok separately, because I saw one of the videos on there. I think it had like a Instagram watermark. And I'm saying this because I noticed for one of my clients, I was helping them out with their TikTok, and we was just putting some of their stuff from Instagram, and TikTok is flagging those videos saying that it's not original content. So I think they're starting to look at if you're posting on multiple platforms. So just be mindful of that. And then look up the hashtag. When you type in like whatever your specialty is, type that in and use some of those as your hashtags too. The Lord's been treating me well. Thank you for asking. Thank you for asking. All right, let's do one more. One more and then I'm gonna go. One more and then I'm gonna go. Anybody else want me to look at their TikTok? And maybe I'll start doing this like once a week or something if I have time. We got to see how this, how much time I'm going to have. Well, this week is probably not the best week because the membership opens. Is there anybody else? Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. Let me know your progress too. Let me know your progress. Yeah, is it your name, Sonya Taylor, or you have another one? Nothing on my TikTok yet. Oh, okay, well, that's okay. You know, and this is not for everybody. Some people, okay, let's see. Some people, this is like, you know, it ain't for everybody. Let me click, because I don't see one when I type it in here. Oh, it's the underscore, okay. That's why. All right, so your Bible bestie, RN, Christian life coach, host of Unapologetic Faith podcast. That's cool. All right, let's see.
I got a question. Do y'all think God cares more about what you wear, or does he care more about your heart? I personally think he cares more about your heart than what you wear, and I think it's a secondary issue. And I see a lot of people commenting like, you're not a true person of God.
Okay, I think some of your hashtags might be a little too broad. Like when you hashtag God or faith, it's gonna put you in a pool with all the 20 other million people that have posted that too. So I would want your hashtags to be a little bit more specific based on whatever you're talking about in that video. I wouldn't use character or heart or even God for that. I would be very specific. Christian TikTok might be okay for now. Because it's the top of the year and not everybody's using that Bible verse, that's good for now. Faith might be a little bit too broad, so I would get a little bit more segmented on your hashtags. That's one of the things I would do. And let me see what else.
One thing that I have learned is that you cannot pursue pleasing God and people at the same time. You cannot do it. You will never please people.
But you know, my best friend is a nurse, and something I've been telling her to do for a long time on TikTok and she hasn't done was do a prayer specific to nurses. specific to nurses. I would do something like that on your page too. That would help you reach over to nurse TikTok. I would do something like that. Let's see. We gotta remember too, y'all, with social media, you got like 3 seconds to get somebody's attention. So you either gonna get their attention in whatever you say really quickly, or you're gonna get their attention with the words on the screen. But whatever it is, you don't make people wait, because they could just gonna scroll on to the next thing. So I'll be mindful of that. So your Bible bestie, what you could do also is show you reading the Bible, or show you reading scriptures from the Bible, since you talk about being the Bible bestie. Showing people the actual scriptures in the Bible, that I see things like that go viral. Posting clips from your podcast might be good too on here. And you might have some. I just probably have to keep scroll some more. But definitely honing in on the hashtags. I think that's going
to
help you.
I told Abraham to go to a place that I would show you. When he got to that place, which was Canaan, he ran into a famine. And
see if there's any. Maybe you need to start your own hashtag too. Maybe you need to start Bible bestie. Let me look up what hashtags in regards to Bible verses are maybe doing well. I know it's going to be like Bible verses for and whatever this topic is. So that's one, Bible verses for, and then whatever that topic is going to be. Daily Bible verses is one, Bible scripture, Bible verses about healing, Bible verses about whatever it is that topic is. You can make sure you put that in the description of your video, so that way you're getting searched, you're getting ranked for that. Because you know, the good thing about TikTok marketing or creating videos on TikTok is when you do it right, you show up in Google. Somebody hit me up some months ago, was like, I was typing in Jehovah Jireh, you know, to get the meaning of it on Google, and one of the first videos that popped up was you talking about Jehovah Jireh on TikTok. And I'm like, yeah, because that's part of the algorithm. Other thing people are searching for, Bible verses for motivation, Bible scriptures, most powerful Bible verses that hit hard, Bible verses, black girl, positive uplifting Bible verses. So that's what people are searching for in that regard. Let me see. And then I would get, and since you are a Christian life coach, maybe start talking about things like that. Wherever you want to send people to, whatever your, you don't even have a link yet, but I think you gotta get a little bit more followers before you get the link, if I'm not mistaken. But whatever you want to eventually send people to, you want to start talking about those topics. So if, let's say you, overall, you have like 3 content buckets, with 3 main things you're gonna talk about, or 4. You're going to talk about being a Bible bestie and what that looked like, and how you help people that maybe need help with the Bible, or you make it simple. You're going to talk about maybe the RN life and how you keep the faith being an RN. You want to talk about Christian life coach, what that looks like, giving people whatever they're struggling with in their life, giving them that advice. And then you could talk about the podcast and giving clips for the podcast. So you can use all of that as your content buckets. But I think this is good. You definitely have potential just getting into the hashtags, and then whatever you're going to say, get to the point. You got to hook them. You got to hook them. You got 3 seconds to hook them. Also, look at the videos for you that got the most views so far, and then do more of that. Do more of that, because your audience is telling you this is what they like. Be careful, everybody. Be careful with the sounds, because they are muting. I see one of your videos at the bottom was muted. But being consistent, too, is another thing, y'all. It depends. I don't tell people you should post this many times a day, this many times a day. It depends how aggressive you want to be. I know people that post 4 and 5 times a day because they're aggressive. I know people that post maybe 2 or 3 times a week because they're, you know, TikTok is not their main thing. So it's totally up to you, but you just want to be consistent. I know with this algorithm, they reward you the more you on here. So think about those things too. Think about, I used to do one-on-ones. I haven't done them in a while. But I used to. Maybe we'll see what the Lord says. Maybe I'll get back into it, because yeah, it sometimes, you know, it's easier to get that one-on-one. But if you're serious about it, send an email, and I'll tell my assistant to like make it happen. You want more help with TikTok? You can join the membership, or if you want like a one-on-one session, I'll do it. You just have to just email or something. Thank you, JesusGirl.com. I got the matching necklace to go with it too. Yes, honey. So if you want to, I haven't done them in a while. I've been, you know, avoiding one-on-ones, but I can. Yeah, join the membership so we can talk about the target audience. And then inside the membership, we have a TikTok course that you can literally go through. And then I'll give you more like stuff, you know, behind the scenes off of this. But yeah, everybody that comes in the membership, I'm gonna make sure y'all good. My goal is for y'all to get results. So yeah, definitely come on board. We open up on Friday. But on Friday, when you come in or whatever, or when the doors open, you'll have access to the target audience. That's the first masterclass, but also the TikTok course is in there as well. You're welcome. I would like to have a one-on-one also if you get back into them. Maybe I should. Let me add that to my prayer targets. One-on-one. It's just, those can be draining sometimes. Because when I go in. Like, before I meet with you, I have this whole prayer session with the Lord. And so those can be like, it's like preaching a sermon. You know, you got prepared for it. So I haven't done them in a while, but maybe this is my sign to go back into it. In my time, I'm so busy. Okay, user. Okay, yeah. I'm a see. You know what I'm saying? I'm a see, user. Because obviously people want it, so I'm a see. Should I do one more before we go? Thank y'all to everybody who's y'all. Anybody on here? Even if I didn't review you or you, there's a lot of notes you could be taking. Yeah. The membership is $35 a month. It's low ticket. It's $35 a month. But it comes with a lot. Like, I didn't even tell y'all, like, some of the stuff that it comes with. You get a private community with other entrepreneurs. You get the course portal where you can take the course and stuff. I mean, take the classes. And then we're going to meet monthly as well. Yeah, so, man, please do what my best friend didn't do and do some prayers for nurses. Please. Well, the Lord leads you to do that. I just think it's a good idea. I would love to see that on Nurse Talk. Yeah. Thank you, user. Appreciate that. Yeah, y'all, because I want all of us to win. You know what I'm saying? Like, we can all be successful and great. We just got to know what we're doing. It doesn't make sense to... Because here's the thing, too, and this is part of the reason why I started this Christian membership. Because I have been a part of a lot of masterminds and signed up for courses. And they start, you know, they give you good meat. But then they start talking about the universe and they start talking about, you know, some of this demonic stuff that I don't believe in. And so it's hard to receive when you're getting that. Yeah, I'm gonna put the replay on YouTube. I definitely will. Thank you. Yeah, this is definitely by faith, y'all. I am launching by faith. And I am slightly nervous, but I trust God because every time he's ever told me to do something amazing happens on the other side. So, I'm launching by faith. I even had to surrender. I had a certain amount of people. I was like, this would be good if I can get a certain amount of people in. I had to surrender that too and say, God, I said yes. I obeyed you. So even if, you know, I let the result, the outcome, the emotional attachment to it, got to be this amount of people. The emotional attachment to it, I let it go. And I've obeyed you. I said yes. Because my job and now I have no free time. It's hard to build a business when you got a full-time job. It takes discipline. It takes no sleep. Like, so yeah, that is hard. I totally feel you. I was in a mastermind and walked away because it was not right for me. Yeah, and so, like, that's the struggle. That's the struggle because, you know, they give you some good tips and things like that, but they also have different people they put on the platforms, and it's just a lot going on. Amen, user. Thank you for igniting my faith. You know, I've been having to encourage myself because the enemy would be like, last time you did it. I did a membership before, but it was during the pandemic. And I had a thriving business, so I couldn't focus on the membership. So it was just way too much, so I had to let it go. So this is like my second time around, and I'm all in this time. I just need somebody that's going to have patience with me. Of course, boo. Come on. Just as long as you come and show up and participate when you can, I got you. I got you. It's hard for somebody to join and they don't have time to look through the material or they don't show up. I know things happen, so you'll always have access to the replay. But I want to help those that want to be helped. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like we're in a season where there's no more spectating. It's all in or nothing. It's all in or nothing. User, are you a preacher? Are you a preacher? Are you a preacher? Is he dropping? He's dropping gems. But yeah, he did need to remind me. And the funny thing is, it's exactly the same time that I did that during the pandemic. I just wasn't ready for it in the pandemic. And mine during the pandemic was more, I think it was Facebook focused, because I was doing so well on Facebook and everybody wanted to know those strategies of what I was doing. Yeah, and God will allow you to do it. God will allow you to do it. You just got to figure out exactly what you're going to do, what you want to invest in your time, what you're comfortable about doing. You don't ever want to sell something that you're not proud of or you don't appreciate. None of that. None of that. All right, let's do one more, y'all, and then we'll wrap up for today, and I'll come back tomorrow. I think tomorrow will probably be spiritual focus about building a business with God. We'll talk from a spiritual aspect. I think you guys like when I talk more spiritual than practical, but unfortunately, well, it's fortunate. We need both. But we can believe God to build the business, but we still got to know our target audience. We still got to know how to speak to them. All right. Anybody else want me to do their TikTok really quickly before I go? Before I go. If not. And the ability to start my business, but I have to tell you, you gotta let you. You know what, Ms. Red? You just gonna have to jump, because it's always gonna be some type of fear there. You just gonna have to jump, and even though I don't feel comfortable, even though you don't know the outcome, everything that I've ever did from God was out of obedience, and I didn't give myself time to think about it. That's the two main reasons people don't leap: fear of failure. And funding, no finances, lack of finances. But if God tells you to do a thing, you do it, because there's provision already laid out for you. Some of you all who may not know my story, you may do. I was broke 2017, broke, busted, disgusted, sleeping on my parents' couch, 3 degrees. Nobody was hiring me, couldn't find a job. I went on a fast and I was praying and I said, God, there has to be more to life than this. Welcome, first timer. There has to be more to life than this, Lord. So I was fasting and praying, and he told me to start a Facebook page. At first, I was like, God, I'm not starting no Facebook page. My car about to be repossessed. Credit cards is high. I need something. And he was like, start a Facebook page. So I said to myself, man, I love God. I don't want to disappoint him. When you really love God, you have a heart for him, you do it. So I did it. I launched the page August 6, 2017. First day I launched it, 10,000 followers. Day 9, 100,000 followers. Now, back then, that was unheard of. But it was my obedience to God. And then somebody, a couple weeks into it, maybe a month into it, this pastor said, oh, the Lord told me to sew a logo into you. He gave me a logo. A few weeks after that, somebody reached out and said, oh, Bishop Noel Jones told me that I should reach out to you because you could help me with marketing. And I got my first client. And I kind of opened the doors for my marketing consulting agency. Yeah, obedience does bring favor. Like, for real, for real. Not for real, for real. I didn't grow up in the church, but I was just kidding. Exactly, user. And sometimes, you know, that's all. That's more than enough. But yeah, that's what it is. And then I've just been growing ever since. Now, up until last year, that page had reached up to 3.45 million followers. And it was booming and booming and booming until last year when I got hacked. But other than that, y'all, your yes opens the door. The things that you don't worry about, the funding. I didn't have no money when I started no Facebook page. I was broke, busted, disgusted, sleeping on my parents' couch, trying to figure out a way to get off their couch. Embarrassed because I'm grown. My grown age, getting laid off from a job, losing everything and having to go back home. And then I had a father who antagonized me. It reminded me that I wasn't supposed to be on his couch. The God that you serve, why he can't get you off this couch. Reminded all the time. All the time. All the time. So I say all that to say, Red, you just gonna have to do it, babe. Just sleep. If God is telling you to do it, just weep. Every day, God did not get in the mirror. God did not give me the spirit of fear, but he gave me power, love, and a sound mind. Figure out, too, what caused that fear. Because sometimes it'd be certain things that happen or some type of rejection somewhere. and give that to God. Surrender it. Surrender the rejection. Surrender the fear. And just say, God, I trust you. And then meditate on trusting God's scriptures. Because you got to build up your trust. Build up your trust. So definitely do that. Definitely do that. This is going to be a great month, y'all. I truly believe it. I feel it in my rah, rah, rah. I feel it. This is going to be a great month. Hebrews 11 and 3 reminds us that the world was framed by the word of God. You want to change the world that you're in, your marriage, your finances, your business, your children, your job. You frame it by the word of God. You find you a scripture, a couple of them, and you begin to decree and declare them until whatever it is you believe in this world has to collide with the word of God and has to become. The word became flesh. The Bible talks about the word became flesh. You got to war with the word until it becomes flesh. You keep decreeing and declaring that word until it becomes flesh. A lot of times people will say the scripture one time and be like, well, God didn't show up. You got to remember, there is a bunch of doubt and unbelief just sitting right here that needs to be uprooted. You got to continue to uproot it with the word of God. Thank you for the roses. You got to continue to uproot it with the word of God. I'm telling y'all, this word right here will work if you work it. It will work if you work it. This is what you got to be spending time working. The word will work if you work it. I have been believing God for restoration, and I have been decreeing and declaring that he will restore unto me the years that the locusts have eaten, the cankerworm, the caterpillar, the palmworm, his great army sent among me. And I feel this scripture getting ready to leap off of these pages in the month of March. Restoration is here, y'all. The cankerworm, the caterpillar has been eaten for a very long time. And it's time for restoration. And even in that scripture, it tells us God wants us to turn our heart back to him and basically repent. Go on a fast. The scripture was telling, go on a fast. And then take the word and just work it, y'all. Take the word and work it. Take the word and work it. Take the word. The word can never return void. You just got to war with it. You just and think about this too. If you didn't go through some of the things that you went through, you wouldn't pray the way you pray. You wouldn't believe the way you believe. So sometimes we have to go through some of the things because it's building our spiritual stamina and character. It's building character. It's building stamina. If I didn't go through betrayal, I probably wouldn't be praying the way I could pray, right? I probably wouldn't tap into realms in the spirit like I can if I didn't go through betrayal. You think about Hannah, provoked, prayer, promise. I like to call her the real PPP strategy, provoked. In that story, in Samuel, Hannah was provoked by her rival. She was reminded every day of the handicap that she couldn't carry a child. Every day, Peninnah would say to her, ha, you can't have no kids. The God that you serve ain't give you no kids yet. You going up to this place and you serving this God and he ain't give you no kids. That provoked her to pray. Hannah got up and she went to pray. The Bible also says she did not eat. I like to say Hannah was fasting because she knew. She was provoked to pray, and then eventually she received the promise. Sometimes we need those. Peninnah is a mocking spirit, a spirit of abortion, a spirit to come and remind you of your handicap, a spirit to come remind you that this thing ain't come to pass yet. Just a taunting spirit. And that pushed her. She didn't say nothing back to Peninnah. She ain't say, I'll pop you. She got up and she went to pray because Hannah knew. The Bible says the Lord closed her womb. I believe Hannah knew the one that closed her womb had the ability to open her womb. Remember that. Remember that, y'all. You got to remember, too. You don't fight the enemy on the same level. You don't fight the enemy on the ground level. You do like the eagle and the snake. The eagle comes down, takes the snake up. Because in the air, the eagle knows the snake has no power. In the air, in your worship, the snake has no power. In your praise, in your prayer time, the snake has no power. Take the enemy from down here and bring him into a level where he can't breathe, where there's no oxygen for him to breathe, where he has no choice but to leave you alone. You got to remember that, y'all. Don't fight on the flesh level. I remember the Lord was telling me when I was going through betrayal, and I was ready, right? It was when I grew up, I was the only girl, so I always was fighting boys. It was head up and shut up how I grew up, right? And the Lord said to me, you can't fight a devil, you can't fight a demon with boxing gloves. He said, boxing gloves carry no weight in the spirit. What you need is the sword. The sword is going to cut down some things, and the sword, more importantly, is going to change you. And that's how I survived betrayal. I started studying David, started studying Joseph, and started trusting God. Started trusting God. Yeah, you don't get nowhere fighting in the flesh. But when you go in the spirit, that shut things down. That'll get them to stop talking. You gotta know where your real fight is. And it's in the spirit. I know it's easy to go back and forth with people on social media, right? It's easy. You know, but that's petty. That's low level. That's a low level. Eagles and chickens, they don't hang out together. They're not even in conversation together. A chicken is literally scratching on the ground, eating poop. An eagle likes fresh meat. An eagle can fly up to, 10, 15,000 feet. And it flies into the storm because it knows that the storm will make it propel even faster. My phone about to die. Y'all got me on here talking. Y'all got me on here talking way more than target audience, but that's okay. That's what we needed. And so that's the whole point of this membership. Like, we can have conversations like this. Reality. This is the real deal. I don't come on here and tell y'all nothing I ain't been through, because it won't. I can't connect to it. I only talk about the stuff that I've been through. I've been through betrayal. And when you have a little bit of influence, it attracts all different types of people. That's why I have learned to be guarded. I was very naive. When you have millions of followers early on, within months' time, that opens the door for you to be invited to anything. At one point, I was getting invited to any Christian platform you can think about. But I had to learn, to always follow where God, only go where God tells me to go. Because there's a grace for where he tells me to go. Thank you so much, Belinda. You be coming on here eating up these girls. Thank you. It's a grace for where he tells me to go. If you don't tell me, don't go connect with such and such in D.C., then I can't do it. I know a lot of times we get these opportunities and we like to jump on them. But if God doesn't give you the release, don't do it. I can't tell you how many times I've been through unnecessary warfare because I was at a place that the Lord did not tell me to go to. So even in your going and your coming and your invites and as your influence is growing, you want to make sure you are well connected to the Holy Spirit so that he can lead you and guide you and tell you, that you don't see what I see. This person, they say they believe in me, but they also do voodoo voodoo. They say they believe in me, but they're out here fornicating, or they out here lying or whatever, stealing. God sees the heart. Yeah, some doors are trap doors. Absolutely. Absolutely. And if you're naive in the beginning, I was very naive. They wanted me to come to, I was getting invited everywhere. Canada, Africa, all these places. And I thank God that the pandemic happened because I was literally probably going to go because I didn't know no better. I didn't know no better until I got some good wise counsel. And they were just like, you can't be really going everywhere just because somebody invites you. And even some of these popular platforms, the Lord has told me no to. It's all good, you know what I'm saying? But that's why I believe in building your own platform, y'all. Building your own platforms. And nobody could ever be like, I helped her, I helped her do this and I helped her do that. She wouldn't even have that platform if it wasn't for me. I'm glad the Lord took me the scenic route, okay? The scenic route, it's okay. And I'm not saying everybody's bad. I'm not saying that about everybody, but you just have to definitely use discerning of spirits as you grow and as you get an influence. Because you're going to notice, once your numbers start going up, all different types of people, they're watching. They're going to see that. And they're going to want to connect. You got to make sure, how did you hear the no? Staying postured in prayer. Saying when it doesn't feel right with my spirit too. Knowing how God speaks to me. When it doesn't feel right with my spirit, I'll be like, no. I live by this principle. It's always a no until God says yes. That's a principle I live by. It's always a no until God says yes. Even when people invite me to come on like their podcast and stuff like that, if God says no, I can't do it. And even if it sounds like simple, right? It sounds like, it's just a podcast, not gonna hurt. But if God don't want me to do it, then I can't do it. Thank you so much, Belinda. Appreciate you. All right. Yeah, when you feel peace about it, then you know, like, God, that's you. That's you. Let me see how much battery. 19%, y'all, and then we're going to be going out here. But yeah, We talked about target audience. We talked about leaping. This is that I was talking about that the other day. This is somebody's year to leap. Like, for real, for real. Like, no cliche. Like, leap. No more spectating. No more watching what everybody else is doing. Aren't you tired of watching Boo Boo and Kiki and build a stuff and build a business and launch and buy their house and buy their car and buy, and you're just sitting around watching them? And you're just sitting around watching them? What are you just going to do? Especially when you got the clearance. Because delayed obedience is still disobedience. Delayed obedience is still disobedience. If God told you to do something and you saying, God, I ain't doing it yet, it's still disobedience. And I was telling the story the other day. You know that sometimes God will, if you tell God no, he'll give it to somebody else to do. He'll give it to somebody else to do. Okay, sorry, y'all. They be asking about a puzzle after a while. Usually it's after you lie for hours and hours and hours, but they've been doing it early. What was I saying? Oh, he'll give it to somebody else. I was telling y'all this story the other day about Dr. Tracy Lynn. She was saying how she got a prophetic word that she was going to write this book, and she rolled around the church and she yelled and she screamed and she was excited for the prophetic word, but she never acted on it. And she went in a bookstore one day, and the exact book, the cover looked similar, the title looked similar, the chapters were similar. The exact thing God gave her, he gave it to somebody else because she didn't do it. She got that whole prophetic word and didn't move on it. You think about Jonah too. Jonah was literally, he was bringing people unnecessary warfare by being on that boat. He was never supposed to be on that boat or that ship. He was never supposed to be there. And because he was on there, he's about to cause everybody else to lose their life. Your disobedience can hurt other people. It can hurt other people. It can affect other people. Imagine how many people are waiting on you. We got billions of people on the earth. Yeah, I'll look at yours and then that'll be the last one. It's the team. Is that O or zero? My eyes are like, you know. Let's see. This is it. I think this is you. Yeah. Okay. Welcome. A scripture daily keeps evil away. God's word is light. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so you definitely need to, if you're advertising like these gummies, I would do a video talking about the benefits of apple cider gummies and what it does. You could say, and I'm just making this up because I totally don't know what this does. If you're struggling with your gut health, I have the best thing to recommend to you. Apple cider vinegar gummies. In these gummies, you get da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You're going to have to explain why these gummies are the solution to what people need. Highlight the problem. What somebody who takes apple cider vinegar gummies, what are they struggling with in their health? What are they going through in their health? So I would definitely do that with those. Let's see what else you got on here. Yeah, so talking about the benefits, highlighting the benefits, highlighting the struggle, what a person who would take those is going through. Let's see. Okay, so make sure you have a description to say exactly what the video is about. Not necessarily for the person, but more so for the algorithm. The algorithm needs to know, where do I put this? So let's say, you know, you have a video about potatoes. If you don't put in the description that this video is about potatoes, it confuses TikTok algorithm, and they're just like, okay, well, I don't know what this is about, so I'm not going to give it much reach. We'll just move on to the next video. So you want to be mindful of that. Always put a description. Yeah, I would more focus on the descriptions. If you're going to be selling those gummies, explain what they do and how they help you. Let's see, what are you else with the scriptures? Okay. Yeah, so with those two, I would put whatever the prayer is going to be about, prayer for, prayer about, put that in your description. Put that in your description. And then hone in and figure out what are some content that you're going to talk about daily. Are you going to talk about the gummies? Are you going to talk about scriptures and prayers? Like, figure out at least 5 content topics that you want to talk about and stick to those. Also, you're following a lot of people. Don't follow any more people. Let's keep it at the 98. We want to get you some more followers and not having more you following them. Did I look at that right? Yeah. We want to get you some more followers. Let's see if there's anything else. Let me search scriptures and see what else people are searching for. People are searching daily scriptures 2024. Daily scriptures 2024. Scriptures for strength. Scriptures black girl. Scripture of the day 2024. Scriptures for women. Scriptures for self-love. Powerful scriptures. Bible scriptures. Scriptures for love. Daily scriptures to read. So those are some of the things that people are searching for. So you can incorporate that. Oh, look at one of my videos pops up. You can incorporate that into your content as well. If you're going to be talking about scriptures. And then let's see about the, I don't know, are those considered, let me see, apple cider. Look, somebody even has content for apple cider for stomach fat. Now, I don't know if that's related to yours as well, but somebody has a video about apple cider benefits. Maybe go look at that. Let's see, somebody has gummies. Let's see what this says. Yep, somebody has the exact, well, not the exact, but it looks similar to the one you're having. Let's see what he said.
Holy crap, did that just happen?
You asked for it, here it is. These are apple cider vinegar gummies. Do they actually work? Well, they work just like my previous video when I actually tested actual apple cider vinegar and you saw the dramatic change. Are the gummies going to work just the same? Let's find out. Before we dive into this, let's go over the macros. So per one gummy is 15 calories.
He's reading like the description and the things like that. People are searching apple cider gummies. Benefits, apple cider gummies before and after, so that's content ideas as well. Apple cider gummies, I think it says black woman. A lot of people are searching black women on here. Apple cider pill benefits. So type in the things that you sell, the things that you want to talk about in the search engine, and they'll give you other ideas in regards to what people are actually searching for, and you want to incorporate that into your description. You want to incorporate that into your description and see about using some of those words as hashtags as well. No, I didn't see your question because I was looking at the computer. So no, I didn't see your question. Okay. Thank y'all again for joining on today. We're gonna come back tomorrow, but tomorrow I'll probably be back in the morning. I think my last couple of times I've been 10 a.m. Eastern. So we'll talk about some more about building a business with God, and I'll see where the Lord leads us. I will put this on YouTube. My YouTube right now is I Need a Word. It's the one I think with 8,000 or 9,000 followers. I think I'm eventually get my own YouTube. Can you explain what Psalm 91 is? The actual Bible verse? Let's see. It's for dwellers. I know that. Psalm 91. Let's pull that up. It's a prayer of protection, but it's very specific to those that dwell. Whoever dwells in the shadow, in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. This is new NIV. I like King James. How much battery left? King James. I don't think I'm going to break down this whole entire scripture, but I will tell you that this scripture is meant for the people that spend time in the presence of the Lord. The first line tells us, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Not God is not looking for part-time lovers. He's not looking for sometimes people that, you know, want to be bothered with him and teeter-totter. This is for people that dwell in the secret place. These are for people that have did like Abraham, and they everywhere they go, there's an altar that they have with God. There's a place where they meet with God continually all the time, and it's a promise of protection for those people, And then I think the ending of it is it's a bunch of promises at the end of it. Because he has loved me, I will deliver him. Because I will set him high, because he has known my name. Those are all promises. He shall call upon me and I will answer. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and I will honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. So yeah, this is for dwellers. This is for people that spend time in the presence of the Lord. This is for people that dwell. This is for people that have a covenant relationship with God. It's protection. It's guaranteed protection. It's a promise. Is it possible to hear everything that the demon is saying during deliverance? I'm not sure I understand that. I also don't specialize in deliverance, so I probably ain't the best candidate to ask that about. I don't specialize in deliverance. One of my friends does, though. Yeah, I don't. When you said hearing what they're saying, you mean speaking through somebody else, speaking through you. I don't know if I even, is your YouTube? Yeah, if you click the Instagram icon, it pops up YouTube and Instagram, that one. Are you the person doing the deliverance? Are you the person that's being delivered? I think that needs to be dissected a little bit more, but that might not be the best person to answer that. All right, y'all, I'm gonna get ready to go. Thank you guys again for joining. We will be back tomorrow, 10 a.m. Eastern. Still going to be talking about our theme, building a business with God. But I'll share, I don't know, whatever the Lord leads me to share. And if we might revisit this target audience again, just in case there's people that join us that haven't joined us before. All right, y'all, let me go charge this phone. Thank y'all again for joining. Thank you for all the gifts. Thank you for all the follows. Thank you for all the shares. Definitely appreciate it. Have a good Sunday. I love you with the love of the Lord. I'll see you tomorrow, 10 a.m. Eastern. Be blessed.